This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Hello and welcome to Enterprising Entrepreneurs. I'm Sanjay Pinto. That was quite a piece. That was from La Pongal. And my guest today is Darbuka Shiva.
Thanks, Sanjay.
Come to why you're called Darbuka Shiva later, but welcome to the show.
Thanks, man.
Band management, not too common in India.
Yeah, especially in South India. But the whole reason of starting this is also the same thing, because it's not common and there are so many good musicians, there are so many good bands, but they need a company which can take care of everything else.
And hence was born Artseek in 2005.
Yeah.
And you're the director and founder of the company. So it's in the nature of a private limited company or a sole proprietorship?
It's a private limited company now.
It's a private?
Now.
Registered?
We are in the process of doing that. Anytime now.
Okay. See, to a layperson, music as a career, especially in India, especially in South India, is not easy. First, you'll have to face peer pressure, family pressure. People say, well, it's okay to perform at college culturals. But to take it up seriously and to actually take it to its logical conclusion is a challenge.
Yeah, definitely. And
tell us about your story.
Okay. Quite similar to what you actually said now. So, I come from a middle-class family from a suburb area. And so, my mother also expected me to get a graduation and go to a job where I can get at least like 10K to start with, so I'll be comfortable and also make others comfortable. And that was the initial idea, but as soon as I got into the college circuit, I figured out that's something that I can never do. And that's when I started getting more serious in music. So in fact, during my third year college, I had already started playing with some very interesting bands, which like a baby like me in the music circuit will never get a chance to usually. But I was really lucky to play with some very senior musicians on the very first group that I played, and I had to go to the extent of bunking my final exams to go for a small tour with the band that I was playing with. So
I can relate to that. I bunked exams to go for debates when I was in law college. Yeah, but yes, go on, I like that.
So that's the end of my academic thing, whatever I did. So finally, exams, I just didn't show up. I had to go for the shows. I didn't even inform my family about this. So
sure, what I find interesting is that, yes, I mean, to actually take up music as a career is a challenge, as we said. But to also help others, to provide a platform to others, like for instance what La Pongal does, you provide a platform to folk art, to a lot of folk artists. We've seen you perform even at our NDTV Greenathon.
Yeah.
You were there.
Yeah.
Tell us about your journey, yes, your musical journey as an entrepreneur so far.
I would say it's been very demanding and it's been really hard.
But as a solo musician is challenging enough. As an entrepreneur, and to give others, that opportunity and that platform.
That's what the whole, the difficult part is for me to manage my creative work and my entrepreneurial work and to get a balance between both. So that
was it. What financial sense does it make? I mean, what's the kind of money you've been making? I mean, it's 6 years now since Artseek was founded.
We've been making enough money for us to fund projects. Like La Pongal is completely funded by Artseek right now.
Mm.
So initially the whole idea was for me to sustain myself. So as a musician, you know how hard it is here to sustain yourself. So after doing that, then I started supporting other musicians who started to work with me on different bands.
Mm.
So that was step two. So I started supporting other musicians. And now Artsik has come to a position where we are programming for lots of venues here in Chennai. Mm. And we are also investing on other bands, like funding for other talented artists who we think really they have a potential.
So you're also doing a lot of mentoring in that sense.
Definitely, yeah.
Okay.
So
where does the money come from? How is the revenue generation?
It's more like a balance that we create. That's what we've been doing so far. We are actually into doing contemporary art forms, promoting contemporary art forms, because we don't want to do something that's already been done. But on the other hand, we need to create a balance. I mean, this needs to be a company which can feed itself and also feed the
employees. So what is the revenue you've seen so far in 5 years?
So, I mean, I'm not sure if I can give it out on figures. I mean,
approximately, I'm give us a ballpark figure just to see how,
like,
you know, how much business.
See, roughly on a month, we do lots of corporate and commercial shows.
Okay.
So there are lots of those kind of things happening. So we try and generate up to 2.5 to 3. We try to generate
2.5 to 3 lakh a month.
Month.
Okay.
On shows, corporate shows and everything. Hmm. So with that, we pay all the artists who perform for all the shows. We take care of all the expenses.
How much would your overheads be? 50% more than that?
As of now, not that much, because we keep reinvesting it again on something else. Mm-hmm. So 60, 70. Yeah.
Okay, and you started off as a one-man army, Shiva. You've got some other employees now? Or?
Yeah. Right now we have a good team working.
Comprising how many people?
Full time we have Sudhakar, who takes care of all the management work and all the coordination, everything, all the back end work. Mm. And we also have Pradeep, who takes care of all the musical related stuff. He's a musical director. He takes care of all those kind of work. Mm. We also have Subiksha, who takes care of the look and feel of the company, designing and like all these things that you see on the wall.
Mm. All this is her work.
Yeah.
Okay.
And this is supposed to be Yodhaka's caricature. Mm. So that's her, that's me.
That's Subiksha in the middle. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So also designing other promotional material.
Yodhaka's is completing what? I mean,
1 year now.
1 year, the first anniversary.
Yeah, so that's happening.
Okay.
Now.
So, okay, I mean, so it's, how has the journey been? I mean, it's tough. It's been a rough ride, right? I mean, it's 5 years. Tell us something about your first contract that you bagged, the first work that you did.
Lots of
under
things.
Under the Artsik banner.
The interesting things I should say was like getting an album deal for Yodhaka, which actually sealed quite a lot of things for us. And you know, it got us into the music circuit. People started recognizing us and all that. So Yodhaka's album was a big turning point.
Mm.
And apart from that, lots of things. In fact, being on Greenathon for 2 years on a national television as Artsik, we are not just like one-off band.
Mm.
We were actually programming two bands for the festival both years. So that, and we also managed to do some really big TV productions also in terms of shows and all that. So in that way, those are some really important deals for us.
Okay. At any point did you feel, I mean, especially when you make a foray into music as a career, did you feel like, okay, I mean, it's one thing to have a passion. It's another thing to have a profession. To make your passion a profession, along the way, did you question yourself?
Never.
Did your parents ask you? Did your well-wishers, your friends ask you? Hey,
all the time.
What did they ask you?
No, everyone had their own doubts about how this is going to shape up. And the thing is, because nobody, I couldn't in fact explain anyone about, I couldn't convey my vision to anyone.
Mm.
Like whenever I wanted to, maybe I couldn't get the right words.
No, because they would have. I mean, yes, Shiva is a talented guy. Yes, he plays so many instruments. He's very good. He's musically inclined. But as a career, not just to feed yourself, but now to feed several other bands and to make them make that mark. A lot of people fall by the wayside in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
They are talented, but then after a while, they give up. They join a corporate job. And perhaps, yes, there as part of their recreational activities, you'll find them playing in a band. But otherwise, as a career, to be persistent about it, is a challenge. How have you, what is that one quality or one factor that's made you stay on into your sixth year now?
Definitely I should say it's the kind of people, you know, who work with me, who also
who share the same passion,
share the same vision and passion, and you know, who work towards this whole thing. And number two is also I've also created a very strong balance, you know, to make this whole thing commercially viable for everyone.
Okay, and you've kept, yes, you've kept your overheads down, which is a good thing. If you get about 3 lakh a month, you've kept your overheads down to about just 60,000. And it's probably because, and again, this is a rented apartment in T Nagar. This is actually, if you can see, a optimum use of space here. It's 3 rooms here, but very creatively done. If you can, what are all these notes, 10 rupee notes? These were what your fans threw from the 10 rupee notes.
No, here. I wish people started throwing all these, but no.
And a little bigger denomination also.
Or maybe dollars. Maybe.
Yeah, dollars would be even better.
These are just some interesting lines that...
What is this? Kumar loves Gomati.
So this has an interesting story.
Okay.
So to complete the story, you need to turn, flip it. Yeah.
Kumar loves Gomati. Gomati weds Saravanan.
Yeah, so now you know what the story is. So this is a very sad 10 rupee note.
Okay.
So anything that's interesting, just... goes here.
Okay. Okay, and this is a sort of a makeshift recording room, is it?
Yeah, this one.
Okay.
And we do all our scratches and all our basic demo stuff here. Mm. For the final recording, we go to a proper bigger studio because we need much more space and proper acoustics. Mm-hmm. But this is good enough to make like, you know, jingles and, you know, ad films. We also do quite a lot of that. And that... getting back to what else
we do. How many projects have you done so far in the last 6 years?
I don't have a count of it, but...
not bad, so you really can't count.
You know, there is quite a lot happening right now, and we've also done quite a lot. In terms of the bands that we've conceptualized and created, we started with Yodhaka first. Before that, I had another band called Zara with Tanvi. And
which? Tanvi?
Tanvi Shah.
Tanvi Shah, okay. Yeah.
I mean, that was my first band.
Okay, the Grammy or the J-Ho girl.
Yeah. So that was my very first.
And you still work together?
We still work together. Okay. Now we are trying to get back Zara into the circuit, but both of us...
That was in 2003?
2003, yeah.
Okay. Now, you're also a self-taught musician, is it? I mean, when you were just slipping out of your teens, you started playing...
Quite late, yeah. Yeah. In fact, I got... hands on music instrument only after I completed my 12th standard. Mm-hmm. Till then, it was just by ear.
Normally, people start off much earlier.
Usually, yeah.
They start off in their, sometimes even children when they start by playing.
No.
You know, my 10 month old son, you play some music and he does the talam. So, yeah. I mean, I think he's musically inclined. Maybe I should send him to you. But
no, at that point, that's one thing that would like horrify me. When I hear music, I mean, initially when I got out.
How did it start? How did the musical journey start? I mean, 17. 17, you were just out of school.
Yeah, technically at 17, but I think my music journey started as soon as I started hearing the first song that I heard. I think
Do Re Mi.
Must be, or maybe in my case might be something else. Mm. Because I still believe that I'm learning music through my ear, and not through any sheets or not through any teacher or
self-taught, anything. As we said. Yeah.
So I think the first lesson I got was the first song that I heard. Mm. So from that point, I started.
Musicians, according to you, are born, not made.
I guess so, at least from my experience. I personally think that you can never teach music to anyone. You can only teach techniques.
Mm.
Music needs to be inside you, and someone can teach you techniques.
Coming back to the various big projects that you've done, you've performed abroad as well, with Singapore, right?
I've performed in Singapore, I've performed in WOMAD in London, Charlton Park, and Singapore Kala Utsavam twice, then performed in Russia, Tokyo for the Namaste India Festival, so quite...
What are some of the big, the milestones in your journey so far?
I think playing in WOMAD was a big, big opportunity, and also for someone like me, who is also trying to create something new, create a new platform, trying to create new festivals. So that was one thing that just changed the way I looked at things. Like Peter Gabriel, who founded WOMAD and Real World Records, like he's always been a big inspiration. So going there, seeing the real thing, that was a big inspiration for me.
Have you been lured by the film industry?
We have some offers and we are working on some. So very soon, there'll be official confirmation.
Okay. What about the threat of audio piracy?
I think we can beat that the way we've done with Yodhaka. I mean, as an independent artist, like, Yodhaka has sold really well. Mm. In fact, close to a mediocre film with decent music. Yodhaka has sold close to that.
How much have you sold?
I think we must have sold at least, in the last year, we must have sold at least some 2,500. Including online and our CD sales and the physical CDs and everything. Another interesting thing we do with Yodhaka is we sell CDs on a live gigs.
Mm.
So people, when they like our music, they immediately buy our CDs. So that's a much better way of selling CDs.
Mm.
Because nowadays we can't expect people to go to a retail store and pick it up from the rack, considering how busy each one is.
Mm.
So if they really like our music, they pick up a CD, and it's been happening for us quite well now.
That's right. All right, time to head into a short break on Enterprising Entrepreneurs. When we come back, we'll talk to Shivar about how he got his name, Darbuka Shivar, and we'll also look at the Darbuka as an instrument. Stay tuned.